Namaste, my name is Gyanendra Kumar and I am biology NEET faculty, right? So today we'll see topic what is plasmid students. This is only for NEET students. So what is plasmid students? See, plasmid is what actually? Our plasmid is a small circular DNA, right? And this plasmid is actually extra chromosomal DNA. Extra chromosomal DNA, and it will be present, generally it will present in the prokaryotic cells. And you know, prokaryote have only one example, that is bacteria. Not in all bacteria, but in some bacteria plasmid will be present. But you know, any bacteria, if you see the main chromosome of the bacteria is a large circular DNA, right? In some bacteria there will be additional segment of circular DNA. That additional segment of circular DNA will be called plasmid. As for example, this bacteria, you see, this bacteria have its main chromosome that is present in all bacteria, but it have additional one small circular DNA that is called plasmid. Guys, this plasmid is actually, you know, it's extra chromosomal DNA. Extra chromosomal DNA means either this plasmid will present here. Of course, if this plasmid will present here, it will show some extra feature. It will provide some extra character to this bacteria. And if this plasmid is absent, guys, then also no problem. Bacteria will survive its life. Bacteria will survive its life smoothly. So it is not essential for survival. But if it will be present, bacteria will show some extra features, right? So it's extra chromosomal DNA. It is actually separate from our main chromosome of the bacteria. Now guys, this plasmid actually, you know, two type. First type of plasmid is called stringent plasmid. Guys, this stringent plasmid have not its origin of replication. Stringent plasmid have not its origin of replication. It's depend on main chromosome for replication. As for example, we have a stringent plasmid. And this stringent plasmid, during cell division, it have to replicate. During bacterial cell division, it have to replicate. So what this stringent plasmid will do, it will come and it will integrate. Suppose this is what main chromosome of the bacteria, right? So it will come, it will integrate into the main chromosome of bacteria. Like you see here, it's integrated here, right? It will integrate into the main chromosome of the bacteria, and when main bacterial DNA will replicate, our stringent plasmid is going to replicate. So it should be very clear, our stringent plasmid cannot replicate independently. Our stringent plasmid cannot replicate independently. But if you see our relaxed plasmid can replicate independently. Why? Because if have its own origin of replication. So as it have its own origin of replication, it is relaxed. It have not any stress that during replication I have to go and I have to integrate here and then I have to replicate here. It can replicate by itself, right? Now, in recombinant DNA technology, in biotechnology, the plasmid we are using is actually relaxed plasmid, okay? In RDT, in recombinant DNA technology, we are using this relaxed plasmid, right? Now, I told that this plasmid shows some extra features, right? Let's see by some example, what are the extra features? Hello students, I hope you have heard one plasmid name that is called F plasmid. Either you say F plasmid, okay, or you say fertility plasmid, it is same thing. The bacteria which have this fertility plasmid, F plasmid, is called F plus bacteria. Hello? This plasmid actually participate in conjugation. Time will come, we will see what is conjugation. So what our ectoplasmid do? Our ectoplasmid actually participate in conjugation of the two bacteria, right? I'm writing here. It participate in conjugation of bacteria. Conjugation of bacteria. Right. One more plasmid have you heard of? That is called R plasmid. This R plasmid actually it's so antibiotic resistance character. This R plasmid so antibiotic resistance character. Antibiotic resistance character. That means suppose we have one bacteria and that bacteria have R plasmid, that means that bacteria will be resistant to any antibiotic. See guys, suppose we have one bacteria. This is actually the main chromosome of the bacteria, right? And it have additional one R plasmid also. And this R plasmid have actually, suppose ampicillin resistant gene is present. This R plasmid have ampicillin resistant gene present. Now this ampicillin resistant gene, which is a type of which present on the R plasmid, actually it will make bacteria resistant to ampicillin antibiotic. Generally we all know antibiotic we are using as a medicine in diseases. For what? For controlling bacteria number, for killing bacteria. But this bacteria, due to presence of ampicillin resistant gene, it will be actually resistant to this antibiotic. It will be resistant to ampicillin. It is going to resistant to ampicillin, right? Many other plasmids are also there. As for example, there is one plasmid, one that is called col plasmid. This col plasmid, you know, is also called colicine plasmid. Colicine plasmid. This colicine, you know, colicine is actually a small peptide. It's secreted by this col plasmid. Our col plasmid secrete one small peptide that is colicine, and this colicine kill the same species of bacteria. Not other species. This colicine, you know, it will kill same species of bacteria. Like we have a population of bacteria, right? Same species of bacteria, but in the same species of bacteria, some bacteria have colicine plasmid, suppose. So they will secrete colicine. They will secrete these are the bacteria, suppose. There is a population of bacteria. In that some bacteria have colicine plasmid. Now this plasmid, what they will do? This plasmid present in the bacteria, they will secrete colicine, which is small peptide. It is going to kill same species other bacteria, right? So it have a benefit. It have competitive benefit here. Clear? So our col plasmid actually code colicine peptide, and this colicine peptide will kill same species of other bacteria. Many other plasmids also there, like camphor plasmid, right? Tol plasmid, toluene resistance plasmid, right? So this is what plasmids that is required for NEET exam. Thank you.